Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can implement matrix addition, subtraction and transpose methods with the help of C language. If you want to watch their algorithmic implementation, so those playlist links are available in the description of this video, so you can follow that. Now, first I am going to implement addition method. So void addition, then I need to pass values here. So this is first parameter int a, size will be 33. So in case of 2D array, whenever we pass arguments, so we need to pass their rows and column size as well. So this is b and third one is c. Now inside this block, I'm going to write the definition of addition. So I'm going to declare two variables, then for loop. So this is outer loop. Inside this loop, I'm going to implement one more loop. And here I'm going to add values and they will be storing into C matrix. So I'm going to add aij location with bij. So this way, this is the first definition, which is adding values of a and b matrix, and those values will be assigned into c matrix. And whatever modification will be done into c matrix, that will be automatically available from where we are going to call this addition method. So now I'm going to copy this. And I'm pasting this. So I'm changing its name to subtraction. Our parameters will be same, loops will be same. And here I'm putting minus instead of plus. So this is the second method, that is subtraction. Now I'm going to implement third method, which is for transpose. So void transpose. Here I'm going to pass only one matrix because I'm going to print transpose of one matrix. So again, I'm going to declare two variables, then for. So whenever we are going to print transpose of a matrix, so rows will be printed into columns and columns will be printed as rows. So here I'm implementing two loops. First is for I, second is for j, and inside this loop I am going to print values of this A matrix. So let's say I am putting %d, then backslash t, and here I am putting AGI. So whenever you want to print transpose of any matrix, so you need to swap the indexes. So in normal case, we use aij, but in this case, we are going to use aji. And after this inner loop completion, we can print backslash n so that output will be printed in form of matrix. So this way I implemented all three methods. Now you might be thinking like I am writing the solution only. You also want to learn how this logic will be working. So you can watch my lecture video for that purpose. So you will be finding a link to playlist that is mentioned as DSA using C. So if you go to that playlist, so I have explained the logic of this programmatic implementation with the help of board. So there you can understand the internal logic how it will be executing. Here I am just implementing the methods so that you can learn how we can process these operations like addition, subtraction and transpose with the help of main method. So this is a complete program that you can use while completing your assignments. So in main function, I'm going to create three matrix. and two variables I, j. Now I'm going to print a message, enter first matrix. Now here I'm going to implement two loops. So this nested loop formation will be reading values of first matrix from the user. Right now we can copy this and we can use it for second matrix input. So just change this first to second and A to B. So this way both A and B matrix values will be provided by the user, and these statements will read those values. Now we need to call the methods that we have implemented before. So first I'm going to call addition method. So I'm calling addition, passing A, B, C as an argument. So A and B having values and C is blank. So this addition function responsibility is to receive all three matrix as a parameter and to fill the addition of A and B matrix into C. And the updation of C matrix will be available into main function automatically. So now here I can print. So I can use printf sum of two matrix and here I'm using this again. So instead of scanf, I'm going to use printf %d / t. And here I'm using C of ij. When this loop will complete, so for new line, we can write printf / n, right? So this way addition will be printed. Now I'm just copying this, pasting this. Here I'm calling subtraction, putting subtraction of two matrix, and the result will be available into C only. And for printing transpose, I just need to call transpose and I'm passing A matrix as an argument. So this way I called all three methods that we implemented above main function. So now this program is complete and ready to execute. So I'm saving this. So before execution, we need to check whether any compilation error is available here or not. So I'm going to compile and run. So it is compiled successfully. So let me share my full screen so that you can see that as well. So I'm just stopping the share. I'm going to share my full screen. Yeah. So now you will be able to that output screen as well. So here you can see it is asking for first matrix values. So let's say I'm entering 4. So 9 times I entered 4 and 9 times I'm entering 2. So 2 is for second matrix, right? So first matrix will be printing sum. First output will be sum, second output will be subtraction, and third will be transpose. So here you can see sum is 6, subtraction is 2, and third is printing transpose. So I just forgot to use the label so that we can identify we are going to print transpose. So here I'm writing transpose, right? Again, I'm executing this. Sorry, I missed semicolon. So again, I'm executing this. So you will see this time transpose will be printed in correct order. So I'm entering this time these values 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Also, you can enter values like this. Right? So here you can see. Though I entered same values in both the matrix, so sum is printed, but subtraction is 0 and transpose is also printed correctly because I entered 1, 2, 3 in row, 4, 5, 6 in again second row, and 7, 8, 9 in third row. But you can see they are printed in column, right? So this way, I hope you understood how we can implement the complete program to implement addition, subtraction, and transpose of 2D array. So again, if you want to watch their algorithmic implementation or you want to understand how these logics are working, so you can just go to description of this video, and there you will find three playlist links. One is for algorithm, second is for DSA using C classroom teaching, and third is implementation of all DSA problems with the help of C language. So follow those playlists so that you can learn data structure in proper way. I hope you understood whatever I demonstrated in this video. Thank you for watching this video.